Boys.
Today we're going to be doing something that's brand new to my channel. You guys have been really sending me a lot of messages about book reviews and leaving comments asking me to tell you guys my thoughts on certain books about Michael Jackson. So I thought we'd start off with this first video of the MJ Fangirl Book Club. I'm very excited about this today. We're going to be starting off with one of the most unique books in my collection. It's called King of Style, Dressing Michael Jackson by Michael Bush. Michael Bush was Michael Jackson's longtime costume designer, and it is super, super chock full of great information about Michael's outfits and costuming through the years. If you guys want to hear my thoughts on the book and hear me discuss some of my favorite Michael Jackson looks, stay tuned. You are now watching MJ Fangirl TV. Okay guys, so this is the book. As you guys can see, it's a really nice size hardcover with a nice embossed jacket. The back of the book looks like this, and it is, like I said, it's really nice. You can see that it has some really large photos of Michael, but also some really good text as well. There are a lot of stories in this book. I'm gonna give you guys a closer look into it now. The really cool thing that I like about this book is that it kind of tells the story of how Michael Bush and Dennis Tompkins, who is his partner, you know, they worked together actually, got started working with Michael Jackson. Michael Bush and Dennis Tompkins were both working at ABC, and they were both assigned to the Captain EO project by happenstance. Neither one of them knew that it was gonna be a Michael Jackson project, and it just so happened that Michael Bush ended up being the dresser of Michael on Captain EO. And night after night, he would, you know, bring the costume home because there would be damage to the pants. I'm not sure if you guys, I'll put a picture here of the Captain EO outfit, but you know, it's like a tight white leather outfit. And Michael was doing a lot of dancing and a lot of movement. And Michael Bush finally said, "Hey, Michael, I am taking the costume home and repairing it every night. And, you know, I can make you a pair of pants that actually fit." And Michael Jackson goes like, "All right, you know, go ahead, take it home. Show me what you got." Next day, Michael Bush brings home the next, you know, the new pants that he made for Michael. And Michael Jackson used them all day long. And then he says, "You know, these pants are great. How did you know?" And the cool thing is Michael Bush shared that he was watching Michael's dancing, and he had the privilege of being on set, so he knew the way that Michael moved, and he knew that it was important to make pants that Michael could perform in that he wouldn't be distracted in. Now, this book is honestly kind of heavy, so I'm gonna put this down for a second and let you guys know my favorite part of the book, which was when Michael Bush goes into the four F's of dressing Michael Jackson. One, fit. Now, does the outfit fit Michael Jackson, right? I mean, Michael's gonna be dancing, there's gonna be a lot of movement, a lot of different choreography. The fit has to be fluid, it has to go with the dance movements that Michael's gonna be doing, whether it's in a video or on stage. And the clothing can't be too bulky, it can't be anything that's too heavy that Michael won't be able to move in. Second is fun. Fun just means, you know, anything that's out of the ordinary. Michael Bush shared that Michael Jackson loved, you know, anything that was different. So whether that be, you know, electricity, you know, things that light up, fabric that's shiny, fabric that makes noise, you know, the clinking and clanking noises. You guys know the bad era was full of that stuff. But yeah, Michael Bush just shared that fun. Whatever Michael wore, it had to be fun. Function. So we talked a little bit about this earlier, but Michael Bush did watch how Michael moved, and the clothes had to function in the way that was best for Michael's total, you know, performance as a whole. So for example, pants needed to stretch, they needed to stretch in certain you know, ways, and then also the pants couldn't be too long, they couldn't be like bell bottoms or anything where it was gonna obstruct his footwork. The clothes just needed to function. And then the last one was first. So first just means, are they the first to do it? Michael Jackson pushed Michael Bush and Dennis Tompkins, constantly pushed them to think outside of the box and to do new things. And for Michael Jackson, you guys know he was such an innovator. And it wasn't just only in his dance and his music. he also wanted to be first in, you know, his clothing choices. And I think as fans, sometimes we overlook the fact that, like, hey, Michael was a really, really stylish guy, and there was a lot that went into it. So this book touches upon so many things that I think as fans we've never even thought about. So the book also touches upon how they made the Smooth Criminal Lean happen live on stage. Now you guys know that Michael Jackson did the Smooth Criminal Lean in the video, but he also did it live on stage in the Dangerous in the History Era tours, and I thought it was really, really cool because Michael Bush shared just the story of how they came up with the idea and how they engineered it together, and how Michael Jackson, you know, encouraged Michael Bush and Dennis Tompkins to put their name on the patent. So it's a patent held by a multitude of people, those three included, and yeah, here's some photos of how they did it. In the video when I think it'd be really fun to talk to you guys about some of my favorite Michael Jackson looks. I love what Michael wore to the 1993 Grammy Awards, that white jacket and the black pants. It was just so classy, and I love Michael Jackson in like those classy outfits. I don't know, it's also when he went to the White House, when President Bush was in office and he met him to receive an award. I also loved that outfit. He looked so regal. Things that were like really simplistic and kind of made Michael stand out. So some of you guys might think this is weird, but I also love the outfit for Speed Demon. Growing up as a kid, Moonwalker was like my favorite thing to watch, and I just loved the Speed Demon video because it was like a combination of like Michael Jackson and also cartoon, and I had no idea that Michael was actually in the Spike costume. So here's a clip of Michael Jackson kind of getting undressed as Spike. And, you know, he takes off the outfit and he takes off the helmet. And I had no idea that that was actually Michael, you guys. Until later on, they released some clips on 2020, I believe it was. And this is a clip of Michael Jackson backstage with Michael Bush and also Karen Fay, his makeup artist. So check it out, guys.
Gloves. Famous gloves, once again.
Where's my tape?
What
you
tape?
Want tape on the outside of the...
Of course.
Tape on the... Well, that's funny.
How could they forget tape?
Obviously, they were not paying attention.
Kind of like we forgot to put the tape on yesterday for your close-up. Kind of like on the close-up that you forgot the tape yesterday.
You had to say something.
And I said something, he's like, shh.
Don't tell it to me.
Why?
Some of the other memorable looks I love are Remember the Time. I also really love the CTE shirts. Now, the CTE shirts is something that Michael Bush made for Michael Jackson's personal use, but he realized soon that it was going to become an iconic piece because Michael wore it to the Oprah interview, and I'm sure you guys have seen it. If you haven't, I'm going to leave a few pictures here. But yeah, I thought that was really interesting. He also included some photographs and information about some of the clothing that he made just for Michael's personal use at home. And he also explained what CTE means. If you guys don't know, all those shirts had the signature Michael Jackson armband and also CTE up here on the side. So read the book, you're gonna find out what CTE means. So before I get out of here, I have one more thing for you guys. I have a surprise. Hold one moment. I'm gonna be doing a giveaway. Yes, so we are gonna be doing a giveaway. I'm giving away one copy of The King of Style, brand new book, and also a copy of the Julian's Auction book from November of 2009. Many of Michael's personal clothing items and other items were given away at this auction, sadly, after he passed away, but the catalog has a lot of fun details on those costumes, and I thought it'd be really cool for one of my subscribers to have. So, if you'd like to enter the giveaway, make sure you guys leave a comment below. Let me know what your favorite tour outfit is. It can be from any tour during Michael Jackson's career. Let me know what your favorite tour outfit is. The giveaway is open to everyone, both international and domestic. All you have to do is leave a comment below and be subscribed to the channel. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope you guys enjoyed this review of the King of Style book. Let me know if there are any other books that you'd like me to go over, and until next time, peace. You've been hit by, you've been stuck by a spoon.